If dramas about international relations are what you live for, then the Netflix original film Sergio might just tickle your fancy. But what about if you're just looking for something great to watch on Netflix? In this biopic, Wagner Moura stars as real-life UN diplomat Sergio Vieira de Mello. The movie focuses mainly on the aftermath of the U.S. invasion of Iraq. There are several other supporting cast in this that you'll recognize. There's Anna de Armas, Brian O'Byrne, Garret Dillahunt, and Bradley Whitford. And I gotta say, it took me a little bit to recognize Bradley Whitford because he was wearing like so much makeup and maybe even a little bit of face prosthetics where the voice I got right away, but I'm looking at him and go, that doesn't look like him, but it kind of does. And then he turned and he had this look to the camera and I was like, yep, that's him. The acting is good and the scenery and the visuals are good also. As we focus on de Mello's life, both before and during, right after the US invasion of Iraq. And that gets to show his involvement as UN diplomat in Iraq and what he does and just his interactions there, as well as his staff as they interact and they try and move forward with plans and work in a diplomatic way. I also like that the filmmakers include real life news footage. So what that does is it just brings an authentic feel to what we're seeing. I mean, you're interspersed with real news footage, so it balances it out. It makes it feel like, hey, I'm actually watching something that is not based on a true story, but is a true story. And I don't know where they draw the line and what has been fabricated or maybe expanded a little bit or maybe just a little exaggerated or if it's all spot on. The story itself is fairly interesting, especially from a historical aspect and just getting to see what goes on in his life and how he deals with all of these different political figures within the region and both during and before the aftermath of the Iraq invasion also. So it's not just taking place right in Iraq. I mean, you get to see as he works and just to see a little bit of how de Mello functions as a person, what really motivates him as he meets with villagers or other people, not just political leaders. But honestly, the film itself, while very interesting, it's not terribly entertaining. I mean, it's not compelling in a way that I just figured a good drama about somebody would be. I mean, from the historical news perspective, it's really good. It is very interesting. It is engaging. And, you know, I found myself interested in what they're saying and what he's doing and just how it all plays out. But as a casual moviegoer or just somebody who plops down in front of the TV to watch this on Netflix, it's not that engaging. I mean, you have to, I really think, be engaged or at least enthralled in political dealings or news or historical aspects to really get something good out of this. Because otherwise, you find yourself just kind of going along and watching an interesting story that doesn't grab hold of you and just go, hey, watch, pay attention. You can't miss any of this. And it's not a bad film. It's just lackluster in the entertainment arena. But you know, unless they're trying to drastically retell history and retell a story and exaggerate it, I don't think that there's much in his life, at least that we're seeing in this, that could make it overly exciting. And I'm not talking about it needs to have all kinds of action and turn a drama into an action film. No, there's just, you can bring a level of suspense or a level of maybe just intrigue and interest into this to make me want to really dive into him and to find out more, to see what makes him tick and all of the interactions that go on between. And especially when you're in a politically charged arena like the aftermath of Iraq. I mean, you have dictatorships falling and new regimes trying to come in and then everybody putting their hands in there and all that. I mean, that gets crazy. And I think that could have been a lot more dramatic and more just intriguing from an anxiety standpoint, or maybe not anxiety because it's happened in the past, so we kind of know what's setting up. That is an opportunity for some tension to be built as they're retelling the story, just to see what goes on behind closed doors as you meet with people who have a different agenda. I mean, you have agendas going on both sides and just what that means as an outcome. And I think that, had they focused more on that, it could have been a lot more just entertaining, engaging of a movie. Now, it's also not to say that there aren't tense moments. There are a couple of little mildly tense moments, and there are some emotional moments as well. And I appreciate that in there. And we get to see the acting come through. And Armas especially, I mean, she gets to be happy and sad and kind of all in between. And you get to see her passion, as well as Moura, who's playing de Mello. I mean, he's good. He was pleasant to watch. I mean, you liked him and he really grew on me. I mean, he had a great screen presence. And at the very end of the film, they show a brief bit of the real de Mello. And I mean, he captured at least what we saw in that very well. So he did an amazing job as far as the acting goes. So if you're into biopics or you're looking for something historical to watch that's also a drama, then you might want to check this out. It's 2 hours long, and honestly, I wasn't bored with it. It didn't drag to me at all. I mean, it moved along. I just wish that it would have had a little bit more in certain areas, maybe cut some other parts out to make it just that much more entertaining from a true movie-going experience. There's sex, nudity, profanity, and violence. I give Sergio 2.5 out of 5 couches. So do you have a favorite drama that is based on true events that you can recommend to me? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this review, please give it a like. Also, don't forget to share and subscribe. I'm Chris. This is Movies and Munchies. Thanks for catching with me.